I quit my corporate job to go full-time freelancer, and I cannot believe I'm saying that right now. I have been wanting to say this for forever, do it for forever, and I'm just so incredibly thankful that it's actually happening. But before we get into everything, I thought I would share some details of how I got here today. For those who are new here, my name is Sonali, and I am 25 years old, currently living in Austin, Texas. I did go to UCF, University of Central Florida in Orlando, for college, and I majored in radio television. I dreamed about being in a sorority ever since high school, so I got to college and immediately went through recruitment and was very involved in my sorority. I was a Kappa Delta there, and I was PR for 2 years, so it was public relations on their exec, and that is where I got really involved with photography and videography especially, because at all their events I was filming and taking photos, and I actually got to do a couple of our recruitment videos, which was so special to me. So I actually started my YouTube channel in 2013, so I was in high school, so I had like a DSLR and I was pretty into photography and videography at the time, but this kind of gave me more of a purpose, and I started really investing my money into like getting the best of the best, like the bodies, the lenses, and all of that, like microphones for videography. So that was really fun for me too. I think it was my sophomore year, one of my sorority sisters asked me if I would do her grad photos and how much I would charge, and I think that was like one of the first times I actually got paid for photography. So when grad season rolled back around, I decided to market myself for doing more grad photos, and that's kind of where my business took off. After graduating from UCF in 2019, my boyfriend and I moved to Austin, Texas, where we're currently living, and he got a job in tech sales while I came here without a job. I was looking for a job, not actively though, because I was like low-key hoping to pursue photography and videography full-time, and I didn't know how I was gonna do it, but I was willing to work my ass off, so like right when I came here, I networked a bunch. I met up with a few photographers and got advice from them. I really tried to, you know, make this a full-time gig. But February rolls around and my older sorority sister tells me that her company is hiring. It was actually a company I already did some freelance work for in college. So I was kind of familiar with the company and kind of just like the culture, and I was definitely interested in getting a stable paycheck. I mean, I was doing pretty good for just moving to Austin with my photography business, but I was definitely, you know, wanting a stable paycheck. So it's a student housing business based in Athens, Georgia, which was kind of crazy because Ryan went to UGA. So I was familiar with like the location and everything, but the position wasn't remote at first, but they made it remote for me, thank God, because I don't know, I could not live in Athens, Georgia. I would definitely not relocate from Austin to Athens. I was originally hired to travel to property sites to take photos, videos for marketing and ads, and to do 360 Matterport tours and drone videos and all that fun stuff. But since COVID hit literally a month after I got hired, I did a lot of video editing for properties that already had footage, or they would send us iPhone videos so that I could make it into a montage for the TVs and the leasing offices, or just like YouTube ads, Snapchat ads, all of that kind of stuff. And I also did the corporate social media, whether that was like coming up with content ideas, getting the content, making the captions. I am not the best writer, and the captions were the worst part of my day. And I would try to like write all the captions in one day, and it would just like never happen. But obviously I did have help from my boss because my voice was just not corporate enough. My team was honestly so amazing, and whenever I would visit headquarters, like everyone was so welcoming and super nice. I think my biggest hesitation for quitting the job was, you know, what if I failed? This was like the best job I could have gotten out of college, and I was scared to lose it. Fast forward to summer of 2021, I was really considering quitting my job and going full-time freelance. Sorry about the lighting, it's getting so bright in here all of a sudden. I was really trying to film this at like the perfect time, but I guess I missed it because it's like literally blinding me, but anyways. Another thing I forgot to mention was the schedule of this job was like so good. It was like a little too good. Basically, I was part-time actually at this job. So I worked from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. and it was Monday through Thursday. So I did not work any Fridays, and I was sure to make that a content day. That's where I would film all my TikToks, sit-down videos, any kind of like brand deals, I would try to get done on Fridays. Even with like this flexible kind of a schedule, I still don't really feel like I had any time for myself, because even after 3 p.m. I would go straight to a photography shoot and probably shoot until sunset. And then I would come home and have dinner and then probably edit photos. And it's just like there was never any time for anything. Don't get me wrong, I actually love to be busy, because I feel like when I stay busy, I am more productive because I don't have time to be lazy and I don't have time to procrastinate. But at the end of the day, it was just like a little bit too much and something I had to give. By the time I decided I wanted to quit, I actually had some December travel booked on my calendar, so I knew I had to wait till December to actually quit. So I gave my notice the Monday of Thanksgiving week, and my last day was on December 13th. So that's a little background on me and my story, and I asked you guys to ask me questions on Instagram in case you wanted to know anything specific about, you know, this whole situation. So let's get into it. The first question was, what was your deciding factor to take the leap? I was just getting overwhelmed with an overflowing to-do list. For so long, I was like scared to lose that stable paycheck, but I've been in Austin for 3 years and have had steady business and clients and all that. And I feel like I've really made a name for myself here with my photography business. So between my Sonali Productions income and all my brand deals, affiliate links, I was just financially ready to do so. The next question is, what did you do to prep? And I didn't really prep, to be honest. I think, again, it was just more financial decision. It was definitely easier to save money because I had multiple streams of income. So I think it was just figuring out if it was financially doable. Other than that, I did talk to my parents and kind of get their advice on what they think was best. And speaking of, the next question is, were your parents supportive? So I told my mom first, and she was definitely supportive from the start. She told me might as well quit my job because I have one more year on her insurance, because I'm 25 and it ends at 26. And by the way, I was part-time, like I said, so I didn't get insurance from my company, so I was still on my mom's insurance. When I told my dad, he called me a dummy, but for good reason, because he was just explaining financially why I should have kept the job. But when I have something in my mind that I want to do, I'm pretty stubborn and like I'm going to do it. So even though his reasons were very valid and very good points, I was just like, I have to quit. And obviously he was definitely supportive of it. How has the process been building your platforms while working in corporate? How have you managed it? Honestly, I don't even know how I've managed it, but I think it was very similar to college, because I had an intern while having a job, while being on my sorority's exec, while doing freelance photography, while keeping up with my YouTube and Instagram. So nothing really changed that much. If anything, I actually have less to do now post-grad than I did in college. But I will say that me and Ryan were actually long distance in college, which sucked, but I was grateful in a way because I didn't have to add him in the mix of like everything I had to juggle. I mean, I obviously still had to like go see him and he would come see me, but on a daily basis, I didn't have to like choose whether I was going to, you know, edit a video or hang out with my boyfriend or hang out with my friends or hang out with my boyfriend. And that was kind of nice. But now I definitely have to be more intentional with the time I'm spending with him, because I feel like I'm definitely a little bit of a workaholic, because it's like work that I like to do and I don't really feel like it's work, because it's fun for me to edit photos and vlog and edit vlogs and all that kind of stuff. So I don't really realize I'm working, but I think that's definitely gonna be one of my New Year's resolutions, is to kind of just like make more of a structure for myself where I can have time for boyfriend time and maybe taking my dog to the park, because I feel like I don't take Sophie to the park very often, and that needs to change because she's a good girl and she deserves it. Next question is, are you going to do wedding photos now? No, I tried it. It was not for me. I started second shooting when I got to Austin because I thought I wanted to go into the wedding industry, but I was very wrong because those 8-hour days are brutal. And also, I was just not down with the fact that I had to work on the weekends, because obviously majority of weddings are on Saturdays. So if I was shooting on a Saturday, I couldn't like really go out and drink on a Friday, because like what if I was hungover, and I wouldn't want that to be a thing. And then on Sunday, your body is like completely in rest mode because you are literally standing for 8 hours straight. So I was just like not about that wedding photography life. I loved shooting weddings just because they're so beautiful and everything's so perfect, but it just like wasn't worth it for me. So I'm sticking to grads and everything else. Like I literally shoot pretty much everything, like engagements, families, what else? High school seniors, literally everything, headshots, except for weddings. So if you're ever in the Austin area, or if you live in Austin, definitely hit me up on my photography account, and you can like DM me for my rates, and we can get talking about dates. That kind of rhymed, that was kind of cute. The next question is, how do you find a discipline to be on camera when you're not feeling great? So I'm planning to have like a few days a week where I batch content so that I don't have to be on camera all the time, because that just does not sound very fun. Although I am planning on getting ready every single day, like actually putting on makeup, whether it's like very minimal makeup, just maybe like mascara, a little bit of like CC cream. I don't know. I'm not really a CC cream girl, so I don't know why I said that, but like, I don't know, just like something to make me look and feel a little bit more alive, because I swear whenever I put on makeup, even if it's a computer day, I am 100% more productive. So I definitely need to get ready and not just be in like sweats. Like I need to like put on like nice clothes and get ready for the day. I want to start freelance photography, but I don't have any experience. Any advice? I would highly recommend to offer friends and families free photo shoots in return for exposure on social media. I actually did a whole video on how to get freelance clients in a new city. I highly recommend you check it out. I gave all my secrets of how I kind of established my photography business here in Austin, so I will link it down below. But offering free shoots is great because you're building your portfolio while getting exposure, and word of mouth is so important in the photography industry. I feel like I've gotten so many of my clients either through word of mouth or Instagram. Speaking of Instagram, you definitely need to have a page for your photography business, and you need to be posting consistently on it, which I am not the best at, but this year I'm gonna get better at it, I swear. I would also consider making a TikTok and like filming behind the scenes of photo shoots and then putting like your photos at the end, just kind of like marketing your work, because honestly, majority of my clients, like I said, I get through social media. Will you be vlogging more now that you have quit? I would love to make weekly vlogs a thing, like consistently every single week I would put out like a weekly vlog. What do you guys think about that? Should I do weekly vlogs, or would you rather me split it up between like a couple days here, a couple days here, and make them a little bit shorter but like more vlogs, or just one long vlog? Let me know in the comments. I really want to focus more on evergreen content, so that means like sit down videos or reviews, like the juicer video I just posted. That was so fun for me to film, even though I know it might not get that many views, but I know it's going to help someone out that's looking for that juicer. So I definitely want to do some more informative videos and sharing my life experiences, but of course I'll be keeping up the vlogs because those are my favorite to watch. What is the next step for you? I first need to tackle that never-ending to-do list. But I also want to kind of just like set a structure for my day. I feel like I'm a very structured person. I like to be in my own home and have my own routine. And now that I'll have more time, I won't have any excuses. So I really want to make going to the gym and working out a priority and get back on my health grind. And I really want to get into healthy eating again. I'm not sure really what that looks like, so I'm definitely going to need to do a little bit more research. But I'm just like not feeling the best about myself right now. And I know that if I put in a little bit of work, like I'm going to see results. So I'm really excited to just start that off in the new year. I'm also wanting to switch up my branding, meaning like fonts and the colors of my brand. I don't know if you've ever noticed, but all of my thumbnails are kind of like similar fonts, similar colors. And I don't know if I want to keep those colors or what, but I just feel like I need to hire someone to kind of like lay it all out there for me so that it can be like as efficient in the future for me making thumbnails, not really having to think about what font or what color or how it's gonna be laid out. I feel like I'm creative, but not in that artistic way. I wish I was, but if you guys know of any really good graphic designers that do branding, let me know. DM me on Instagram. I would love to check out their work and possibly work with them. Speaking of branding, I'm also wanting to do a full-on branding photo shoot next year. I feel like I always take my photos of myself. Like, I'll do like a self-portrait situation, or Ryan will take my photos, but I want to hire a photographer to take my photos. We'll rent out a space, and I'll have like a couple outfits, and first of all, it'll be so fun, and second of all, I just need new photos of myself, like really good headshots for media kits or just my social media profiles. I feel like I've had the same profile picture for so long now, and it's only like the profile on my face, like this. So I definitely need to look into that, and I'm really excited to start planning that out. For photography, grad season is quickly approaching. I think my first session might be in like January or February. So if you guys know anyone in the Austin area, definitely go send them my profile. It's Sonali Productions is my photography account. And I'll definitely be focusing a lot of time for marketing for that. So that wraps up this video. If you guys have any other questions, be sure to comment them down below and I'll answer them. And I also wanted to give you guys a huge thank you because without you, I probably would not have been able to go full time. And I'm just really, really excited about all the content that I'm going to create for you guys in the future. I'm going to list out all the accounts that you can follow me on through this journey because I have quite a bit. So we got Instagram, we got TikTok. Both of those are @so_gnarly. You can subscribe to me here on YouTube for vlogs. And then you can also follow my Amazon storefront, which I update like pretty much daily now. I'm obsessed with Amazon, as some people would say I'm addicted, but there's so much good stuff on my Amazon storefront, from home decor to jewelry to kitchen stuff, glassware, all of that, fashion pieces, it's all there. So definitely go check that out and follow me because I sometimes go live on Amazon and you can get notified when I go live there. And then lastly, you can follow me on my Like to Know It profile. This is kind of like where bloggers and YouTubers, Instagrammers, anything like that will post their exact links for their outfits. So if you guys have ever wondered where anything's from on my Instagram page, it's most likely linked on my Like to Know It. And a huge thank you to anyone who's ever used any of my affiliate links in the past and in the future. It really truly means a lot to me and I'm just so grateful for you guys. So I guess that's it of this video and I will end it here, but definitely go follow me on all my other social platforms to kind of just stay updated in my everyday life, and I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.